What age does she become an orphan? At the age of 6. How many out there would think Zainab bint Ali, Allah, how much he loves her, she loses her mother at the age of 6. But when she loses her mother at the age of 6, did she learn anything from her mother Fatima? No one thing. Our children are like sponges. The question some of our kids are asking these days shows you just how bright our children are if the parents dedicate time to those children. Sayyida Zainab, 6 years old when her mother Fatima al-Zahra died. But subhanallah, the lesson she learned from her mother Fatima, which she applied into her life. What was the first lesson? Be politically active and never be silent when there is oppression. Because she saw Fatima al-Zahra, there was a number of occasions where she did not stay at home when she was needed politically. Sometimes in our communities, women are told that stay away from politics. This is not a world of women. You shouldn't be involved in politics. You are going to be in a compromising situation. Fatima al-Zahra, when Zainab was how old? When she was 4. Fatima al-Zahra had already taken a political role in the event of Mubahala. When she had represented the Muslims on that event with the Christians of Najran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had ordered in the Quran, فَمَنْ حَاجَّكَ فِيهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ فَقُلْ تَعَالَوْ نَدْعُ أَبْنَاءَنَا وَأَبْنَاءَكُمْ وَنِسَاءَنَا وَنِسَاءَكُمْ وَأَنفُسَنَا وَأَنفُسَكُمْ. Allah had ordered at that political event. Zainab was only 4 at the time. She saw her mother leaving the house. Today, the stereotype about the Muslim woman, she has to stay at home, has to cook, has to clean, she's oppressed. Zainab saw the Fatima leave the house to represent the religion. While what? While she was only 4 years of age. But then a couple of years later, she saw that when her dad had a political and spiritual issue that was taking place in Medina, did her mother Fatima Zahra stay at home? Did her mother Fatima Zahra say, listen, it's a woman's role to be silent, this belongs to men? On the contrary, she saw with all the oppression her mother faced, her mother gave one of the most eloquent speeches Islam has ever seen. Yes. That sermon that Fatima al-Zahra gave, having been oppressed, having been injured, Zainab was how old when her mother gave that sermon? Zainab was around 6 years of age when her mother gave that sermon. Her mother, while injured, stands in front of the men of Medina. You know, when we look later on at Sham, you think Sham was a coincidence when Zainab stood in front of Yazid? Zainab had drunk from the fountain of Fatima, yes? When Zainab stood in front of Yazid later on, where do you think Zainab saw this from? At the age of 6, she saw her mother Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, while injured. There's others who will say, I will not get involved. Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam, while injured, left the house and made it clear that you are opposing us on the issue of Fadak. Who knows the Quran more, me or you? Because if you say that you are more aware of the Quran than me, and you say that the prophets do not leave behind inheritance, did not Allah in the Quran say, وَوَرِثَ سُلَيْمَانَ دَاوُدَ, did not Sulaiman inherit David? She tells. Then the second thing she says is what? If you say prophets don't leave behind inheritance, then did Allah in the Quran not say about Ya'qub, not say that Zakariya wanted someone to inherit him and it was Yahya? Look at Fatima's usage of the Quran. Zainab echoes it later on. When a daughter sees her mom in Quran, the daughter then wants to be involved in Quran. When the daughter sees the mother has no interest in Quran, how then do I expect the daughter to have an interest in the Holy Quran? Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam turned around again. She saw her mother Fatima. First verse, Sulaiman, Dawood. Second verse, Yahya, Zakariya. Third verse, Surah 2, verse 180. Kutiba alaykum, idha hadara ahadakum al-maut, intaraka khayran al-wasiyyatu lil-walidayni wal-aqrabina bil-ma'roof. It is prescribed upon you that when you reach death, that you leave a will behind to your near ones. She asks the first Khalifa in the famous discussion. She says to him that does not the Quran say you leave behind a will, and that will there is meant to be an inheritance for the near ones? Therefore, Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam, in her childhood, the first lesson she learned from her mother Fatima was a political lesson. That Zainab, never let there be a day where they tell you not to be politically outspoken. Oh Zainab, when you see oppression occurring, speak. Don't stay silent. I'm your mother, Fatima. I could have stayed at home and not said a single word when they took what they took. But when they took Fedak, I spoke. When they took your father's authority, I spoke out against them as well. She witnessed all of this, but beautifully she witnessed the spiritual side of her mother, Fatima. There's a spiritual side. What is it? That when you serve and think about the creation, that is service to the Creator. Because she says, I was sitting next to my mother Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. I see my mother Fatima in dua and in Salat al-Layl. Look at the influence of the mother on the young Zainab. Because Sayyida Zainab in Karbala, many people ask, how could Zainab stand and do Salat al-Layl after all that happened in Karbala and Kufa and Sham? It was Fatima's influence at a young age. That Fatima wanted Zainab to see the way she balanced politics, spirituality, and her social responsibilities. Sayyida Zainab says, I see my mother Fatima recite dua. I hear her reciting dua and are praying for the community before praying for us. And my brothers would say, Mom, you pray for others before us? She says, Al-jar, thumma dar. Our neighbors, then we think about ourselves. Because some families, what will they do with their children? The main thing is us. You have to get a good degree. You have to get a good job. You have to be the best in school. Say, but how about the rest of the community? Forget the community for now. You are number one. Sayyida Fatima alayhi salam, what did she do with Zainab? Zainab, come here next to me. Whenever you read a dua, and this is one of the conditions for dua to be accepted, by the way. Many times people ask, that why is it that our duas are not accepted? One of the conditions is that you pray for others before you pray for yourself. That you think of others before you think of yourself. Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam sees her mother do that and sees her mother in Salat al-Layl praying for the forgiveness of the community. Sometimes it's hard to pray for the forgiveness of others. I want to think about myself only. And how many of you, when you've come to pray Salat al-Layl, you're thinking of the names of the people. You think mom, dad, him, her, and then you think of them and you're like, why are they in my Salat al-Layl? Yes. You don't want to pray for her or you don't want to pray for him. Sayyida Zainab, Fatima al-Zahra, from a young age, tells her, my daughter, politically stand up against the oppressor. Don't remain silent. Your mother will lose everything to make sure Dhulm does not succeed. And secondly, socially, you have a responsibility that even if nobody is with you, think of the creation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look after you. 6 years of age, Zainab loses her mother. Yes, many of us would give up on life. Many of us would attack this world. Do you know how many people email me today? I'm depressed. I'm suicidal. There is no way out for me. I hate this world. I've been tortured. I ask you one question. Learn from Zainab when she lost her mother in that pivotal moment. Did Zainab alayhi salam turn around to her Lord and say, you know what? This is all your fault. Did she turn around and blame the community? The community is full of hypocrites. I don't want to join the community. I hate the community. They're all against me. No, on the contrary. Zainab taught us a fundamental lesson. Even at that young age, be proactive. Don't be someone who keeps thinking depressively about what's happening to them. Rather, use what Allah has given you to give back towards the community. Yes? Today, when there are people out there who complain about the community, look at that young Zainab. The first thing she does after her mother's died, many would cocoon themselves. Many would give up on the community. Zainab alayhi salam, first thing she does is that she turns around and she says, you know what? I learned from my mother and my father many things. My father's role in my life is he continues to give me knowledge at all times. You know, her father and hers relationship is something unique. Her father, from a young age, would always open to her the beliefs of Islam in many different ways, so that one day Zainab would use that energy to go and teach the Muslim community. Yes, she herself says, from a young age, my dad would sit with me and he would say to me, Zainab, who do you love the most? She says, Dad, I love you the most. Zainab, who else do you love? She said, Dad, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said to her, but Zainab, you cannot have two loves in one heart. She'd say, Dad, because of people like you, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes. Young age, Imam al-Sadiq says, the right of your daughter is you engage in dialogue with them. Yes? Talk to them. Open the different beliefs with them. Another occasion, he would say to her, Zainab, let's count. She would say to him, what are we doing, Daddy? He said, let's count, me and you. She'd say, okay. Say one. He says, one. What comes after one? She says, one. Says to Zainab, what comes after one? Says one. Says no, Zainab, two. She said, Dad, a father who has taught me to say there is only one, I cannot say two. Yes, young age, she uses that at a young age not to attack the community that killed her mom. Many of us would attack the community that killed our mom. Many of us would walk away from that community, never talk to them again. You know what Sayyidah Zainab did? Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam turned around to the community. She turned around to all of them and she said, how many of you love the Quran? Some people turned around and said, we are the lovers of the Quran. She said, okay, very well. In my house, every day, tafsir of the Holy Quran.
Yes.
Subhanallah, every one of the sisters, every one of the brothers here, all of us have a gift in one way or the other with Ahlul Bayt's knowledge. You don't have to be someone who's a genius in knowledge.